Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel all about electronics. So in this video and the subsequent videos, we will learn about the diode. And these are the following topics that we will cover in the series of videos. And in this particular video, we will learn that what is diode and how the VI characteristic of the diode will look like. And we will also see the equivalent circuit for this diode. And in the subsequent videos, we will learn about the device physics of this diode and we will also see the different applications of the diode. So now the question is, what is diode? Now we all know about the resistor. It is the most widely used type of passive circuit element and it allows the flow of current in both direction. Similarly, this diode is a two-terminal semiconductor device which allows the flow of current only in a one direction. And if you see the symbol of the diode, then it looks like this. So here, this arrow indicates the direction in which this diode allows the flow of current. Now the one terminal of this diode is known as the anode. And the second terminal of the diode is known as the cathode. Now, whether this diode will allow the flow of current or not, it depends upon the polarity of the voltage that is applied between this anode and cathode. So, if the voltage that is applied between this anode and cathode is positive, then in general we can say that this diode will allow the flow of current in one direction. While the voltage that is applied between this anode and cathode is negative, then it will not allow the flow of current. So now when this diode is connected in particular circuit and if you want to analyze that circuit, then the circuit can be analyzed by knowing the voltage and current that is flowing through this diode, and that can be found using the VI characteristic of the diode. Now for the resistor, we know that it is a linear element and the relationship between the voltage and current is linear. So using the Ohm's law, we can easily find the voltage and current through this resistor. But unlike the case of resistor, the diode is a nonlinear element. So the relationship between the voltage and current for the diode is nonlinear. And moreover that, this diode allows the flow of current only in a one direction and it almost blocks the current in the reverse direction. Now if you look this graph, then it looks like the graph is symmetrical in both directions. But don't get confused by the symmetricity, because here in this graph both positive and the negative axis have a different scale. For example, on the positive y-axis, we have a scale in milliampere, while on the negative y-axis, we have a scale in microampere. Similarly, on the positive x-axis, if you see, the voltage varies like 0.5 volt, 1 volt and 1.5 volt. While if you observe on the negative x-axis, the voltage scale varies like minus 10 volt, minus 20 volt and minus 30 volt. So because of the different scale, this characteristic looks symmetrical on both axes. But if you keep the same scale on both axes, then the diode characteristic will look like this. So as you can see, in the reverse direction, the current that is flowing through the diode is almost negligible. So using this VI characteristic of the diode, we can easily find the voltage and current that is flowing through the diode. And using this, we can easily analyze any circuit which contains these diodes. But because of the nonlinear characteristic of this diode curve, it is a bit difficult to find the voltage and current very easily. So what we can do, we can approximate this diode characteristic and using this we can analyze the circuits. So first of all, what we will do, we will consider this diode as an ideal diode, and for this ideal diode we will see the VI characteristic and also we will see the equivalent circuit for this ideal diode. And step by step we will introduce few more parameters to this ideal diode, and using this we will approximate the diode characteristic curve. So for the ideal diode, whenever the voltage that is applied between the anode and cathode is positive, then simply it will act as a closed switch. On the other end, if the voltage that is applied between this anode and cathode is negative, in that case simply it will act as an open switch. So now let us see the VI characteristic for this ideal diode. So in the case 1, when the applied voltage is positive, on the VI characteristic we will get the vertical line. And for the case 2, when the applied voltage is negative, then for that case we will get the horizontal line on the negative x direction. So this is the VI characteristic for the ideal diode. So now whenever the positive voltage is applied to this diode, then it can be said that the diode has been forward biased and it will allow the flow of current. While on the other end, whenever the negative voltage is applied to this diode, then it will not allow the flow of current, and simply we can say that it has been reverse biased. So we will talk more about this forward and reverse biased at the later part of the video. So now let us take one simple example in which the diode is connected in series with the voltage source and the resistor. Now here we are assuming that the diode is an ideal diode. It means that whenever the voltage that is appearing across the anode and cathode of the diode is positive, then simply it can be represented by the closed switch. And as you can see over here, the applied voltage across the diode is 10 volt. So simply it can be represented by the closed switch. And the current that is flowing through this 100 ohm resistor will be equal to 10 volt divided by 100 ohm, that is equal to 0.1 ampere. While on the other end, if we apply the minus 10 volt in this circuit, then the applied voltage across the diode will be minus 10 volt and it will not allow any flow of current. So simply it will act as an open switch and the current that is flowing through the circuit will be equal to 0 ampere. Now some of you might have a question that how to find the voltage across this diode. So that can be found by finding the Thevenin's equivalent voltage between these two terminals. So simply you need to remove this diode from the circuit and you need to find the Thevenin's equivalent voltage between these two terminals. So if you remove this diode, then the Thevenin's equivalent voltage which appears between this anode and cathode in this particular case will be equal to minus 10 volt. And because of that, the diode will be non-conducting. On the other end, whenever the 10 volt is appearing between these two terminals, then diode simply will act as a closed switch. Now if you see the VI characteristic of this ideal diode, then you can observe that even if we apply very small positive voltage between this anode and cathode, then also this diode will start conducting. So let us see, even if we apply the positive 0.1 volt between this anode and cathode, then also this ideal diode should start conducting. But if you see the actual diode, it will start conducting only after the applied voltage cross some threshold voltage. And if you see the VI characteristic, then it will look like this. So up to certain threshold voltage, the diode will not allow any flow of current. And whenever the applied voltage crosses this threshold voltage, then only diode will allow the flow of current. So this voltage is known as the threshold voltage or the cut-in voltage for the diode. Now like I said before, this diode is a semiconductor device and usually it is made up of either silicon or germanium. So for silicon, this threshold voltage used to be in the range of 0.6 to 0.7 volt, while for germanium usually it is around 0.3 volt. So actually the diode will start conducting once the applied voltage crosses this threshold voltage, and before that it will not allow any flow of current. So this is the first approximation for the diode curve. So here in this approximation we are considering this diode as an ideal diode, but it will only allow the flow of current once the applied voltage crosses this threshold voltage, and the equivalent circuit will look like this. So in case of reverse bias, it will simply act as a open switch, but whenever the applied voltage crosses this threshold voltage, then only it will allow the flow of current and simply it will act as a closed switch. So now let us take the same example that we have taken earlier. So in this approximation, we are considering this diode as an ideal diode, except the fact that it will allow the flow of current only after the applied voltage crosses the threshold voltage. And here we are assuming that the diode that is used is the silicon diode. So it has a threshold voltage of 0.7 volt. So once the applied voltage crosses this 0.7 volt barrier, then only it will allow the flow of current. Now here, as the applied voltage is 10 volt, so simply this diode will allow the flow of current and the equivalent circuit will look like this. So now if you find the current that is flowing through this 100 ohm resistor, it will be equal to 10 volt minus 0.7 volt divided by 100 ohm, that is equal to 0.093 ampere. While on the earlier case, when we have considered this diode as an ideal diode, at that time we found the value of this current as a 0.1 ampere. So using this approximation, we can find the more accurate values of voltage and current in the circuit. Now in the same approximation, suppose if we apply the minus 10 volt, then in that case the circuit will simply act as an open switch and it will not allow any flow of current. So the current that is flowing through this resistor will be equal to 0 ampere. Now in this first approximation also, we have considered that the diode has a zero resistance, and that can be also visible from the VI characteristic of this diode. Because if you observe over here, once the applied voltage crosses this threshold voltage, then the voltage that appears across the diode will remain constant and only current will increase. It means that the diode offers the zero resistance. But in actual case, every device has some finite resistance which will limit the current that is flowing through that particular device. So now let us consider the second approximation, where we are also considering that the diode has some finite resistance. And in that case, if you see the VI characteristic, then it will look like this. So up to the threshold voltage, the diode will offer infinite resistance, or simply it will act as an open switch, and then after it will provide some finite resistance, and that resistance can be found from the slope of this curve. So this resistance is also known as the bulk resistance or the body resistance. So this resistance is the resistance that is offered by the semiconductor device out of which this diode has been made. So now let us see the equivalent circuit for this second approximation. So whenever the diode is reverse biased, in that case simply it will offer the infinite resistance, or we can say that it will act as an open switch. But whenever the applied voltage crosses this threshold voltage, in that case now it will offer some finite resistance of RB, that is the bulk resistance of this diode. So this is the equivalent circuit in case of the second approximation. Now apart from this bulk resistance, diode has one more resistance, and this resistance is present in the diode because of its internal structure. So we will talk more about this diode resistance in the separate video. Now typically the value of this resistance used to be a few ohms. So in the circuit, if the Thevenin's equivalent resistance which appears across the diode is much more than the diode resistance, in that case the diode resistance can be neglected. But if the Thevenin's equivalent resistance which appears across the diode is comparable to the diode resistance, in that case we also need to consider this diode resistance. So for example, in this case let us assume that the diode has a resistance of 25 ohm. Now this resistor is comparable to this 100 ohm resistor, so we need to consider this diode resistance. So if we consider this diode resistance, then the current that is flowing through this 100 ohm resistor will be equal to 10 volt minus 0.7 volt divided by 125 ohm. And if you see the current, it will be equal to 0.074 ampere. So because of this diode resistance, if you see, now the actual current that is flowing through this 100 ohm resistor will change. So using this second approximation, we can find the more accurate value of the current and voltage that is flowing through the circuit. But in most of the circuits, the Thevenin's equivalent resistance which appears across a diode used to be a much larger than this diode resistance, and simply we can neglect this diode resistance. So in this second approximation of this diode, we have assumed that the diode is non-conducting till the point the applied voltage crosses the threshold voltage, and then after it offers some finite resistance. So if you see this type of characteristic, then it is known as the piecewise linear characteristic. Because what we have done, we have segmented the actual characteristic of this diode into the piecewise linear characteristic. So up to the threshold voltage, we have assumed that the diode is non-conducting, and after the threshold voltage, it will offer some finite resistance. Okay, so now let us talk about the actual curve of this diode. So in this diode curve, like I said before, this region is known as the forward region, because once the applied voltage crosses the threshold voltage, then the diode starts conducting, and whenever the applied voltage is less than the threshold voltage, in that case the current that is flowing through the diode is almost negligible. Now whenever we apply the reverse voltage to this diode, then that region of operation is known as the reverse region of operation, and in this region the current that is flowing through the diode used to be a very small, typically in the microamperes, and this current is known as the reverse saturation current of the diode. So as you can see from the graph, even if we increase this reverse voltage across the diode, then also the current will only increase by marginal amount, but we cannot increase this reverse voltage indefinitely, because if we go beyond certain voltage, then the diode will come into the breakdown region. So this region of operation is known as the breakdown region, and this region of operation should be avoided. Now some diodes are specifically made to fit in this particular breakdown region, and this type of diodes are known as the zener diode. So we will talk more about this zener diode in the separate video, but for any normal signal diodes, this region of operation should be avoided. So if you see the data sheet, you will find that the maximum breakdown voltage for the diode has been mentioned, so the applied reverse voltage should be less than this breakdown voltage. Now in the forward region of this diode characteristic curve, if you observe, as the voltage across the diode increases, the current that is flowing through the diode will increase exponentially, So in data sheets, you will also find one more parameter that is known as the maximum allowable forward current. So diode current should be less than this maximum allowable forward current. So here are the few parameters that we'll find in the data sheet of any diode. So now in the next video, we'll talk more about the diode resistance. So I hope in this video you understood what is diode and the VI characteristic of the diode. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.